Praise the Lord, everybody. How many glad to be in God's house today?
Hallelujah.
Y'all give God some praise.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Give God some praise.
Hallelujah.
Praise.
Glory to you.
Y'all can't be sitting like we have a funeral.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
How many glad they woke you up this morning?
Amen. Amen.
I can clothe in your right mind. I used to say clothe in my right mind, but clothe with the mind of Christ.
Amen. Amen.
That's a different than your right mind. Your right mind might not be right. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to welcome you to another exciting experience here at Spirit of Truth Christian Center Church, where Bishop Victor and Jacqueline Creagh are the pastors. Facebook Live, we want to welcome you. And we also want to keep extending this invite to you. Come on in here and worship with us live. We're taking necessary precautions to make sure everyone is safe.
Amen.
We got social distance. We got somebody at the door taking your temp, so don't have to be afraid.
Yes.
He's not giving us a spirit of fear,
amen,
but a power of love and a sound mind.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
You're not going to catch anything here but the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for another awesome opportunity to come and fellowship around your word. We don't take it lightly, Lord. We decrease that you may increase all of you and none of us. Holy Spirit, we say you are welcome. Come in, saturate us with your presence. We thank you for signs, miracles, and wonders that shall take place today. We thank you for those that shall be saved in here and by Facebook Live. Filled with the Holy Spirit and coming into the knowledge of the truth. And Father, we would be so careful to give you all praise, all honor, and all glory for what shall transpire in this place today. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Y'all give God a shout of praise.
Hallelujah. Glory to your name, O God. Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Wonderful to be in the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah. At this time, we have prayer of agreement.
Thank you, Lord.
At this time, if you have anything you want to bring before the Lord, this is your time to do so. Whether it's a prayer of healing, deliverance, if you have an issue going on, you need wisdom from the Lord this morning. The Word of God said He gives, if you ask for it, He gives wisdom liberally and upright or not. That means He won't hold anything back from you this morning,
amen,
right?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
If there's anything you want to bring before the Lord, even if it's on somebody else's behalf,
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody going through, you have a friend or loved one suffering, have an issue. If you want to stay in the gap, you can do so this morning.
Amen.
You know, there's power in prayer.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The prayers of the righteous avail as much.
Amen.
Amen. It does above and beyond.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Lord. Well, there's no one who needs prayer this morning. We still have our corporate prayer, corporate confession. And PS me. We are healthy.
We are healthy.
We are wealthy.
We are wealthy.
We are wise.
We are wise.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Oh, to you.
my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other. It reaches to me. You are my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other. It reaches to me. You are my strength. You're my strength, Lord. strength like no other. It reaches to me. You are my strength. You're my strength, Lord.
Strength like no other.
Strength
like no other.
And
it reaches to me.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
How many of y'all doing all right this morning?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
It's okay. You clap your hands. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Listen, let me tell you something. You have to learn how to praise God.
Amen.
Wherever you are, whatever's going on, just go ahead and praise God. Amen.
Amen.
Is that all right?
Amen.
I'm going to give you a chance again. Come on, put your hands together.
Hallelujah.
Come on, give the Lord the praise. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We've been dealing with this series, and I hope that you guys have been really taking good notes on this series, because it has been a really good one to me. Yeah. Amen. You've been getting blessed by?
Amen.
All right. So what we've been talking about is why go to church.
Yeah.
And it has been proven, it's everywhere, that church numbers are falling off. People are not going to church. People are confused about why go to church. There's all kind of things that are being said. But what we found out is that we're going to church because we want to be that people that's prepared to meet the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. How many of you know he's coming back?
Amen.
Come on, talk to me now.
Amen.
He's coming back. And because he's coming back, you need to be prepared to meet him. Somebody says that the sheep be on the right, goats on the left.
Mm-hmm.
So there's going to be a separation. There's a separation of the wheat and the tare.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you understand that there are some people that are going to go back with him, some people are going to be judged, all of us are going to have to stand before the Bema, the judgment seat of God, mm-hmm. and at that time we will get a reward for the works that we've done. Did you get that?
Amen.
Somebody say my works.
My works.
Okay, there's a time for that. But also you need to know that there is a judgment for the righteous and the wrong, mm-hmm. or the right and the wrong. Mm-hmm. And so with that being said, you need to be prepared to receive the gift of the righteous.
Amen.
You need to be prepared to be in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
Only those who have received Jesus, only those who have received Yahshua himself, mm-hmm. Will be that says, well done, my good and faithful servant.
Amen.
You've done well down here. Come on up with me. Amen.
Amen.
So what we want to do is we want to try to go into just a little bit of review. Pastor Jagger told me, be careful with my review because it takes too long, but I got the review. And so, because you need to be caught up on what I've said. I hope, again, that you've taken good notes, all right? Amen. Listen at this now. Let's do this. Let's pray. Father, we thank you and honor you for this time of fellowship around your word. Thank you for these, your sheep that have come. Thank you that the word goes forth unhindered by any satanic force, and it will accomplish all that it's been sent out to do. All right, go with me right now in your Bibles. Those of you who have your Bibles, let's go to, where do I want to go? Let's go to 1 Peter chapter 2. 1 Peter chapter 2. Amen?
Amen.
All right. praise God. We're gonna get into this morning. And I'm gonna deal with 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 through 17. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 through 17, and I'm going to be reading to you from the New Living Translation. In review, here's what we've done. We've talked to you about the power and the spirit of Elijah.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen.
Luke chapter 1, verses 13 through 17. Luke chapter 1, verse 13 through 17. The power and the spirit of Elijah. Mm-hmm. Remember, In Luke chapter 1, in those verses, what he talks about is that Elizabeth and Zechariah is getting ready to go in, or Zechariah is going in to minister in the temple. He's the priest that ministers in the temple. Mm-hmm. I share with you that there's 24 divisions of priests. Mm-hmm. How many?
24.
Don't forget that. There's 24 divisions of priests. Mm-hmm. Zechariah's division is the eighth division. His dad, I believe, is Abijah. Don't hold me to that, but I think that's Abijah is his dad. That's that eighth division. The number eight, biblically, the number eight means new beginning. Mm-hmm. Amen? So God is so in control that at this particular time, when God wants to do something new, when he wants to start over, he has Zechariah in the temple ministry. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
God is in control. Don't forget that. He's in control. Mm-hmm. Now, God has not spoken. Hear this real good. Mm-hmm. God has not spoken for 400 years at this point. Mm-hmm. You hear nothing from heaven. The last thing you heard in Malachi chapter 4, verses 5 and 6 is that I am going to send you the spirit and power of Elijah. Mm-hmm. Amen? And when he comes, I'm going to send him, because if not, if I don't send him, I'd have to put a curse on the earth.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Right. Amen.
Amen.
Now, remember the first time that there was a curse on the earth is in Genesis chapter 5, mm-hmm. when the angels came down, took women and took them as their wives, and they bare children. Mm-hmm. And those children were the Amalekites, or the giants, the Nephilims. Mm-hmm. Amen? Amen? So what God did was he sent a flood and destroyed everything. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
So watch this. He says, if I don't send you the spirit and power of Elijah, I'm going to have to put a curse on the earth. Mm-hmm. And God had already promised. Watch this, Sister Geraldine. You'll love it. God had already promised, I'm going to show you this rainbow to say I'll never flood the earth again. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen?
So God has already made this promise that he's not going to curse the earth like that again. Mm-hmm. Did y'all get it?
Amen.
So he said, I've got to do something for you in order for you, for me not to put this curse on the earth. So I'm sending you the spirit and power of Elijah. The spirit and power of Elijah, again, folks, is to give you the right, the privilege, the honor to worship the Hebrew God. Mm-hmm. Because what the world was introducing, or what Satan had introduced to the world, is Baal worship.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Amen?
Amen.
What's Baal worship? This idea of excess without God.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This idea of abundance without God. And the only way you can get it is through mixture. Mm-hmm. Hear me real good. So he said, I'm sending this, and that's what he did in Luke chapter 1. Now, in Luke chapter 1, remember Zechariah and Elizabeth. It simply means, their names mean God's remember his oath. God remembered his oath.
Yeah.
And when he remembered his oath, he gave them John, grace. Which is grace giver. So I'm going to have to send grace to the earth. If not, the curse will get you. Mm-hmm. Oh, y'all better hear me.
Mm-hmm.
Grace is not a topic. Grace is a person.
Amen.
And Jesus said, Lord, I've come through the volume of the book to do thy will, O God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sacrifice and offerings thy would have not. Mm-hmm. Burnt sacrifice, burnt offerings, you had no pleasure in.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Listen. Your sacrifice, hear me real good, outside of Yahshua, Jesus himself, God is not pleased in.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Amen.
Oh, there's some people that are sacrificing family just to get what they want.
All right.
And he says, I'm not pleased in that. You need to do it my way. Amen. Amen. Number two. I share with you three things that prepare us mm-hmm. to meet the Lord. What were those three things? We have to watch, pray, and be lovers of the truth. Okay? So you got that? Number three. I gave you three things that could prevent us from being prepared to meet the Lord. What was those three things? Suffering. Also known as carousing. Drunkenness. Drunkenness has nothing to do with alcohol, but it could include alcohol. The third thing is the cares of this life. Yeah. When you meet people that only concerned with what it takes to live here, like there's no life after. Yeah. Yeah. Amen? Like there's no judgment coming. I even share with you that we are already under judgment. How many of you know that God didn't deliver Israel in one fell swoop? Yeah. Mm-hmm. If I'm not mistaken, there were 10 plagues. Mm-hmm. Amen. Mm-hmm. We see that 2019, everything was fine, and you woke up on 2020, and nothing's been the same.
What you say?
Amen.
Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
So judgment has begun.
My God. Yeah.
Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
Now, watch this. We had Corona. Mm-hmm. COVID-19. What we looked like we were coming out of that hole? Delta. Mm-hmm. Looked like we were coming out of that Delta hole?
Yeah.
Omicron.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are y'all hearing me? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you need to stop living your life like there's no life after.
Amen.
You should stop living your life like there's no judgment.
My God. Yeah.
Come on, talk to me now.
Amen.
Listen. He says, I, in order for you to get miss the curse, you got to take the grace.
Yeah.
Oh, watch this. God, he's the same yesterday, today, and forever, right? Mm-hmm. He doesn't change, right? Mm-hmm. He said, I set before you life and death. Mm-hmm. Bless and curse. Mm-hmm. He said that way back in Deuteronomy, didn't he?
Amen.
He says, okay, I'm going to set that before you. Choose life that you and your seed might live.
Yeah.
Amen? So here we are. We're dealing with these things. And remember 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 3 through 1. Paul wrote this. He says, I don't need to write you about the signs of the time. You know that.
Yeah.
You know we ain't never had to wear masks or what?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know we've never had to taste 6 foot, you know.
That's right.
6 feet.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
So why should I have to write you about the signs of the time? You listen. Me and big old Luke, we said, man, it must go rain because my knees hurt me. We know the signs of the time. Amen.
Amen.
So Paul says, I don't need to write you, but what's going to happen is it's going to be just like a woman travailing in birth pains. Mm-hmm. And out of nowhere, her water breaks.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then it intensifies. Delta was killing people like not. We thought just straight COVID-19 was bad, but that Delta. So, how many of you are taking Omicron serious?
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
So watch this. When God sent Moses to tell Pharaoh to let his people go, what did Pharaoh, man, you come in with that little stick turned into a snake. Come here, boys. Throw yours down, too.
Yeah.
Don't take that serious. We can do that. We can get over that. We can handle that. Mm-hmm. Amen. I'm just going to wear my mask and do my thing and, you know. Okay. That was number three. You got number three?
Mm-hmm.
Number four. Here we are today at number four. Number four is, I need you to know how God sees you. If you are the people, and you are. Amen. Come on, get this. Mm-hmm. I was late for prayer this morning because I was talking to another pastor on the phone, and he said that he believed that we are the people, but he had some issues. And so we were trying to discuss the issues.
Mm-hmm.
But listen, folks, you're the chosen people of God.
Mm-hmm.
You're the true Hebrews.
Mm-hmm.
Don't question that anymore.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Listen, if you don't believe it, go and look at this message by Stephen Darby called "Who Are We?" Look it up on YouTube. Mm-hmm. Who are we? And in that particular message, he goes into DNA proof. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
E1B1A.
That's right.
E1B1A mm-hmm. is the haplogroup.
Mm-hmm.
That haplogroup goes all the way back to Shem. So now, you know the people who are in Israel now?
Mm-hmm.
They say when you talk about them, you being anti-Semitic.
Yeah.
You can't be because you are Semitic.
My God.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
Those people who are in Israel now have no DNA proof, no DNA link to Shem.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
they are not E1B1A.
Yeah,
they are not. But you are.
Amen. Yeah.
You don't believe that? I'll show you mine. E1B1A. Are you hearing?
Amen.
Y'all hear to be a preacher like that? Revelation 2:9. Revelation 3:8. Those people who. Watch this. He said, there's a people who are in the temple who say they are Jews, but they are not. They lie.
Yeah.
Read the book.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Watch this. He says, when he gather all his people from the four corners of the earth and bring them back to their place, mm-hmm. there will be peace in the earth.
Mm-hmm.
Well, why are they fighting over that? Is God a liar? Luke chapter 21, he says that until the fullness of the Gentiles, Jerusalem shall be trodden down. They're dropping bombs over there every day.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Didn't he say, watch this, Stephen? He's going to gather his people from the four corners of the world where he scattered them into slavery.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Come on.
Well, the only slavery they can talk about is Hitler.
Yeah.
They wasn't in slavery in Jamaica. They wasn't in slavery in Africa. They were only in slavery under the Germans.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Okay. Deuteronomy 28:16. He says, because you will disobey me, and I know you're going to disobey me, I'm going to send you back to Egypt into slavery in ships. And nobody's going to want to purchase you or buy you or bring you out of it.
Yeah.
And we still in trouble to this day.
All right.
They're putting knees on our necks.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They are wanting to give the highest congressional honor to people who shoot folk down in the streets.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Are y'all hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So don't question, are you the people? That's why when you pull up here and you read the sign, let's pray that God's people return to him.
Amen.
You know, on the billboard out there?
Yeah.
Amen.
Because we don't know who we are. We're killing ourselves. Now, you know, we can get upset when other people kill us, but we need to be really upset when we're killing ourselves.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
It matters to us.
Yeah.
Amen. We need to be really upset with that because God's people are out of place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Remember two reasons why God chose Judah? You are the tribe of Judah. Mm-hmm. Two reasons why. One was to give birth to the Savior. Jesus came through the tribe of Judah. He's the lion mm-hmm. of the tribe of Judah. So he came from us. So the dude looked like us.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Okay. The
cat,
the dude, the fella,
yeah.
Bruh, look like us.
Mm-hmm.
Watch it. Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
He looks like us. I seen this guy. It was kind of interesting. The guy took, I was like, you know, they do some crazy stuff on TikTok, man.
Yeah.
But this guy took this penny. Anybody got a penny?
Yeah.
Well, you know the penny, you know what a penny looked like, right?
Uh-huh.
It's bronze.
Right.
Right?
Uh-huh.
So the revelation again, Stephen said, that Jesus looked like burnt bronze.
Uh-huh.
So he took a lighter uh-huh. and held it to the penny
uh-huh.
and let it just burn.
Yeah.
That was my color. That dude darker than me. If that's what, you know, the Bible says.
Yeah.
Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
Yeah. So don't question that. You're his people.
Mm-hmm.
And because you're his people, now he says, don't forget the second reason why I chose Judah. I chose Judah for the second reason is so that Judah can introduce me to the world.
Yeah.
So Judah can represent me.
Amen.
Well, y'all better hear me.
Amen.
See, Esau, the second Edra says that Esau is the beginning of sorrow. Y'all hear that?
Mm-hmm.
Now remember, Jacob was the twin
yeah.
of Esau.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Esau is the beginning of the trouble.
Mm-hmm.
But Jacob is the beginning or the end of the world.
Yeah.
So the problem that they have with us is they know their time running out.
Mm.
And the first gonna be last.
Happy
first.
Yes. That's their problem with us.
Yeah.
That's why they want to keep that knee on our neck. Because,
yeah.
Listen, if you get on top or if you get in the position of leadership, they're going to say, oh my God, you think they're going to do us like we did them?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But see,
yeah.
the Most High didn't put that in you.
Amen.
No matter how much you say stuff and talk about folks, you can't treat them like that because
yeah.
it's not in you.
Yeah. Amen.
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 And the reason why we are where we are is because we disobeyed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We disobeyed. And guess what? We're still disobeying.
Amen.
Now, there's a lot of stuff out there to tell you you're disobeying them because you eat bacon. You have to understand that if you're doing anything dietarily,
mm-hmm.
it's for health reasons,
right.
not for righteousness reasons.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Did y'all get it?
Yeah.
Amen.
You don't eat that because it's not good for your health.
Right.
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 Not to be right with God.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Amen.
Oh, y'all better hear me.
Yeah.
Amen.
Because he said, don't you dare call come unclean.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Or whatever they set before you, bless it.
Yeah.
Now y'all be praying every time you eat.
Amen.
That's right.
Another reason why y'all be praying is because he said he'll bless your bread and your water and take sickness out of the midst of you.
That's right. Yeah.
Are y'all hearing?
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. We need to study some of these dietary things and really cut them out.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're not good for our systems.
Right.
Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
Amen. You know, because, you know, we lead in a lot of areas that we're not leading in.
Mm-hmm.
Kidney disease.
Mm-hmm.
Diabetes, high blood pressure. Amen.
Amen.
All right. All right. So number four, since you are the people and you are in this mode of thinking, this way of living, where you're being prepared to meet the Lord,
mm-hmm.
now you need to know how he thinks about you, how he sees you,
mm-hmm.
what he thinks of you.
Mm-hmm.
You need to know, I want to say who you are,
mm-hmm.
and that has been proven that you are the chosen, right?
Right.
That you're God's people.
Mm-hmm.
Whose you are, but really how the Father sees you. And I want to take it and show you something here from the perspective of being priests.
Mm-hmm.
You're a priest.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in order for you to get this, you have to remember that God chose a certain group of people to be priests.
Mm-hmm.
That lineage, that 24 division of people,
yeah.
all come from Aaron, Levi,
mm-hmm.
Aaron. Amen.
Amen.
And that those were the only people who could go in before God to make sacrifices and intercede on the behalf of others.
Right.
But I'm going to show you, says Yeshua, that's his name, Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Yeshua HaMashiach, get that.
Mm-hmm.
Because he came, now you're all priests and kings unto your God.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. Look at what he's done for Judah.
Amen.
Now, Judah needs to understand also that according to Exodus chapter 12, when God delivered Israel out of Egypt, a mixed multitude went with it.
Right.
Yeah. Did y'all get that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you can't have a hate in you that y'all the only one.
My God.
Okay? Because any man who call on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. Now you have to be careful because the heart of Edom is to grab the hearts of men.
Mm-hmm.
They want to rule men.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They want to dominate men.
Mm-hmm.
That's when you know an Edomite.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Can I? Oh, no, I'm not going to put that on. No, I'm not going to put that on. I don't want to mess you up. But Esau is, Edom is the same as Esau.
Mm-hmm.
That other brother.
Yeah.
You want to tell you how he looks to me? Huh? He red and he got a lot of hair on him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you like that, huh?
That's how he looked. And the hair is not woolly, it's just straight.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah.
So you watch the heart of Esau, because what Esau did was he sold his birthright.
Mm-hmm.
Now get back to the priesthood. When you are the firstborn, you have the right of the birthright, which means you are immediately, automatically put in the position of the priest of the house. Glory to God. So you're the one now that's responsible for making sure that the house go well. You're the one responsible for making sure that the sacrifices are made for the house, that the intercession is made for the house.
Yeah.
Because you are the firstborn. Oh, glory to God. And so because Esau sold his birthright, it went to Jacob.
Right. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
And what he did was he put his own needs and desire before the need and desire of the Most High.
Amen.
So because of that, God says, I'm giving it to Jacob.
Yeah.
Esau, I hate it.
Right.
Jacob, I love.
Mm-hmm.
I heard Donald Gray Barnhouse said, it's amazing. What's amazing about that statement is that he could love Jacob.
Trickster.
Come on, y'all better hear me.
Yeah.
See, because what Jacob is good at is being a trickster.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You ever want to be tricked, just go to the hood.
Yeah.
We know how to do it. It is so ingrained in us that Reuben, Esau's great grandson, said, don't kill Joseph, let's sell it.
Yeah.
You ever want to be sold out? Hang out with the homies. We know how to sell one another out. Listen, it was ingrained. You trying to figure out why we sold one another out when we got over here? You know, I'm gonna be the house boy, you're gonna be the field boy, and I'm gonna tell master because it's ingrained in us.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't know who you are. You bound to repeat the mistakes of your past.
Mm-hmm.
And we have no trouble, we have no problem selling one another out. Because that's what Reuben, who was it? Reuben.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he did. No, that's what Judah did, I'm sorry. He sold us out. And I'm saying, my goodness, I didn't know that. That's why we do what we do. That's why we talk about one another the way we talk about one another. That's why we tail on one another. Yeah. Don't kill it. I ain't gonna kill you what I'm gonna say. I will stab you in the back. All right. So you gotta know how God sees you, right?
Amen.
You are being prepared to meet the Lord.
Amen.
So you need to know how God sees you. In 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 through 17, and we'll look at that. And don't forget now, you have to understand that you're a priest.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
You have to understand that you're a priest. Let me give you this before I read this too much, go into this too much. So what Aaron did and what we have as priests is a twofold responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
It's a twofold responsibility. To sacrifice and to intercede. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
As priests unto our God, at the position that God has put us in, our responsibility is to what? Sacrifice and intercede.
Amen.
Amen. Now, you do understand that intercession is not just for you.
Mm-hmm.
It's for others. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Now, watch this. When you learn how to pray for others, you'll stop selling them out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Amen. Isn't that good?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Bitch, that good.
Yeah.
It's praying that'll keep you in a position where you won't sell your people out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Amen.
Watch this. It's praying that'll keep you in a position, in a posture,
thank you, Lord,
where you won't hurt your own people.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
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 Now remember, not just ordinary prayer, but I'm talking about intercession.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Pray for others.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Because I'm not concerned. You're going to pray for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Amen.
Come on. Talk about it.
Amen.
You're going to pray for yourself.
Yeah.
Amen.
But it's others that you have a problem praying for.
Yeah.
Because you put yourself in a position where you always keep yourself before God.
Mm-hmm.
And your needs, right, your family, your thing. Amen. Mm-hmm. But watch this. You forgot you were a priest.
Amen.
Yeah.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Listen. If you born again,
mm-hmm,
if you name the name of Christ, you're a priest.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
That's how God sees you.
Yeah.
You need to stop allowing yourself to be seen as something less,
mm-hmm,
than the priest.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
You are a priest. You just like Aaron.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Aaron didn't have the grace. They don't have to tie a rope around your leg,
mm-hmm,
when you go in before God.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because grace has made it where you can come boldly before the throne.
Yes. Oh, glory to God.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, watch this. Grace has made it where you can come just as you are before God.
Amen.
You can come to God with your problems.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
You can come to God with your shortcomings.
Thank you.
You know that you're not always right, but you can still come.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
So that twofold is sacrifice and prayer, an intercessory prayer. Watch this. Our sacrifices are with our body, Romans chapter 12.
Mm-hmm.
Praise to God. How many of you know that? That's a sacrifice. You don't always want to do it. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Especially when things are not right. Come on, talk to me.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when somebody's sick.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Especially when bills are due.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm.
When you're in a tight, when it doesn't look like it's going to work out. He says, that's the time to make the sacrifice of praise to God.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Because what God does is he inhabits the praises of his people.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Watch this. When you praise God, it steals the avenger. It stops him in his track.
Mm-hmm.
Satan was trying to do something, and he was trying to get you to get into the pity party, but you flipped the strip on him, and you started praising him, and he had to stop. Wait, wait, we can't operate like this. Mm-hmm. This is not an environment for us to operate. Let's go find some other idiot.
All right.
Watch this. Watch this. Mm-hmm. You ought to make a sacrifice with your substance. Uh-oh. In other words, I know you need it over there, mm-hmm. but God is asking you to put it over here.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
That's huge, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Especially with the light bill due, baby needs a new pair of shoes. Got a phone bill too.
Didn't he?
He worked it out.
Thank you, Lord.
When you know how to make the sacrifice of your substance.
Amen.
Also, the sacrifice of your service is necessary.
Yeah. Amen.
All of us get tired.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
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 There's a menu, like my granddaddy at Selvin Adams used to say. There's a menu of Sundays I don't want to come. But I made the sacrifice.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to lay in the bed last night. We went off and I come back and I wanted to lay, you know, kind of like Alabama fans did right around the third quarter. Just wanted to go to bed.
That's a wild one.
I wanted to do that. But I had to get up because I had some stuff running through my head and I need to get it on paper. I had to make that sacrifice. That's my service to the Lord. that statement I made, that was a service to the Lord.
Okay.
Amen. So you have to get out of self in order to serve Him.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense to you?
Amen.
Amen. My time to get over. Watch this. And the next thing is that we have to pray on the behalf of others. Amen. So all of those areas of sacrifice, mama, and praying on the behalf of others. Amen. God's got you,
mm-hmm.
priest. Hello?
Mm-hmm.
You the priest, God got you.
Amen.
You called, God got you. Pray for other people.
Amen.
Yeah.
Intercede for other people.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen. I know you hurting. You may be physically hurting, but go lay hands on somebody else that's sick.
Amen.
Watch God do it.
Amen.
Oh my God, I remember 1993.
Mm-hmm.
My mama was in ICU. And I would hear of somebody
mm-hmm.
in the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
I went to every room I heard. Laid hands on people were getting healed.
Amen.
But we were still down there in that chapel fighting for mama.
Mm-hmm.
Still going to that ICU room every hour. That, you know, on no visitation.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But we never stopped. If I heard somebody that you know, that so-and-so in the hospital, let me go over here and pray for them.
Yeah. Amen.
Because he proved to me right there, I got you.
Amen.
How is anything going to get done? How is it people are going to be reached if your only thing you're concerned about is you and yours?
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
Listen, you want to be able to minister in spite of, not Amen. Just because of.
Amen.
Amen.
So I need to know how he sees me. He sees me as a priest, right?
Uh-huh.
All right, you ready for the scripture now? Verse 9, 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 through 17, New Living Translation. Here we go. But you are not like that. You're not like those other people, for you are a chosen people. Didn't I tell you that?
Mm-hmm.
You are a chosen people. You are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's very own possession. As a result, you can show others the goodness of God, For he called you out of the darkness into the wonderful light. I think King James says marvelous light. You see how God sees you? You're the priest.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
You're not like other people. You pray for people. You show people God's good. Listen, when you walk in, they say, oh, look at the goodness of the Lord.
Amen.
Every time you open your mouth, they say, listen at the goodness of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
When you do what you do, look at the deeds of the goodness of the Lord. Oh, that the God's so good. They try to thank you, but they don't understand. It's not you. It's the goodness of the Lord. How you do what you do, then you tell them it's the goodness of the Lord. Let me tell you about the God I serve. How good he is. Listen, that's why you're so hospitable. That's why people like to hang out at your house. That's why people always want you in the group. Listen, we're going to do something. Don't you want to go? We want you to come go with us.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because you're a priest. You got that goodness thing on you.
Thank you, Lord.
You got that thing in you that everybody, oh boy, just love to be around you.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, Lord.
Because that's who you are. That's how God created you. That's how he sees you. Verse 10 says, once you had no identity as a people. Listen, Hebrews. They told you you came from nothing. They lied to you and said, oh, man, we bless you by bringing you here. You wasn't doing nothing but running in the woods with loincloths on. And now we know better. We know that we're the people that started it all.
Yeah.
You better know who you are.
Amen.
You better know how God sees you.
Amen.
Watch this. He says, once you had no identity as a people, and now you are God's people. Somebody say, I'm God's chosen people. Once you received no mercy, now you have received God's mercy.
Yeah. Thank you.
Verse 11, dear friends, I warn you as temporary residents and foreigners to keep away from worldly desires that wage war against your very soul. So this is not your home. Stop acting like there's no life after.
Yeah. Amen.
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 You don't have to put everything you do on Facebook.
Yeah.
Come on.
Amen.
Everybody don't need to know you balling like that. Come on.
Uh-huh.
Y'all putting stuff on Facebook, man. Aren't you? I can't get no amen.
Amen.
Listen, you everybody don't need to know what you're doing.
Uh-huh.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You can't go nowhere without putting it on faith. Now look, that's your business. But I'm telling you, right here, stop. Notice what he said. Keep away from worldly desires. Keep away from worldly desires. Stop living like it's just about the cares of this life.
Mm-hmm.
Like there's no other life. You know, you got to know what kind of car I drive. You have to know how big my house is. Come on, stay away from all that foolishness. Because what it will do is it'll put you in a posture where you'll stop praying for others and the only thing you're concerned is about you. But if you're in that posture where you're praying for others, where you're making sacrifices, it's not just about you. Now let me say this to you. None of us, all of us, each and every one of us have bad actions. Each and every one of us have bad thoughts.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
But when you're praying, when you're watching, it warns you about your bad thoughts and actions.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I tell you, don't think like that. Mm. Don't think like that. Because if you're in a position where you can give, and then you start thinking about, oh, I'm always giving to these folks, they don't give nothing to me. Listen, God always giving to you, and you don't give nothing to him.
Hmm. All right.
Yeah.
And he's blessed you to be in a position where you can give.
Amen.
So stop that foolishness. Watch this. He says, verse 11, dear friends, I warn you as temporary residents and foreigners to keep away from worldly desires that wage war against your soul. Be careful to live properly among your unbelieving neighbors. Mm-hmm. So it matters what people think.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't care what nobody think.
Yeah.
See, that's foolishness.
Mm-hmm.
It matters what people think because you're a priest.
Amen.
Watch this. Listen, what people think should not dictate how you live.
Mm-hmm.
It should not dictate what you allow God to do in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Are you hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not going to let people think wrong of me just because I don't care.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Because I'm a priest. Are y'all hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
He says, be very careful to live properly among your unbelieving neighbors. Then, if even if they accuse you of doing wrong, they will see your honorable behavior, how you live,
mm-hmm.
and they will give honor to God when he judges the world. So watch this. When they stand before God, they have to say, they can't say, I ain't never seen nobody do that before. No, you're a liar. You saw your neighbor do it, the priest that was next door.
Uh-huh.
Come on, talk to me.
Uh-huh.
Watch verse 13. For the Lord's sake. For whose sake?
The Lord's.
For whose sake?
The Lord's sake.
Not cause you, no other reason. Mm-hmm. Somebody said, for no other reason.
For no other reason.
Not cause you scared. No, for no other reason. Watch this, Stephen. For the Lord's sake, submit to all human authority.
Mm-hmm.
Whether the king as head of the state, or whether officials as he has appointed, for the king has sent them to punish those who do wrong and to honor those who do right. Mm-hmm. So we do it for the Lord's sake. It is God's will that your honorable lives should silence those ignorant people who make foolish accusations against you.
Mm-hmm.
like Daniel.
Yeah.
They wanted to kill Daniel because of how he lived before them.
Mm-hmm.
They said, listen, you know the story. We're gonna set him up because he's gonna pray to that God.
Mm-hmm.
So they went to the king and said, listen, don't nobody pray to nobody else but you. King said, yeah, that sounds pretty good. Let me pass that law. Not knowing that Daniel prayed every day.
Mm-hmm.
But guess what? When the king found out that he had passed the law against Daniel, it broke his heart.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But now, of course, he passed the law according to the Medes and the Persians. When you put it out there, you can't take it back.
Mm-hmm.
And so the king says, Daniel, I'm just believing that God you pray to. Go save you.
Yeah.
And he did.
Yeah.
And what happened to Mordecai?
Right.
What happened to all those other people?
Yeah.
Well, a different story. Those people got thrown into the lion's den themselves.
Yeah.
Mordecai was with Esther.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Watch this. Verse 16. For you are free, yet you are God's slave. So listen, all things are lawful to believers. Yeah, you can do it. Yeah, you can put anything you want to on Facebook. But it's not expedient.
Yeah.
It's not beneficial for you to do it. Yeah, you can. Listen. People step to you, you can cuss them out. You got it right. But it's not beneficial.
Yeah.
It's not expedient.
That's right.
He says, we do stuff for God's sake. Why? Because we're free, but we signed up as slaves.
Yeah.
We agree. I won't be a slave. Because you're a good master.
Mm-hmm.
Are you all right?
Mm-hmm.
Watch verse 17. No. 16. For you are free, yet God's slave. So don't use your freedom as an excuse to do evil.
Mm-hmm.
Don't do that. Mm-hmm. Verse 17. Respect everyone and love the family of believers. Fear God and respect the king. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Now, let me give you number five real quick. Number five. And we're going to close this series. This is the fourth installment and I think the last one. Number five, final instructions. These are our final instructions. Let's go to First Thessalonians chapter 5. And we're going to this time look at it in the Message Bible. First Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 through 24. Verses 16 through 24. You're God's chosen people.
Amen.
Amen. You got it?
Amen.
You're not just somebody sitting on a pew or a chair this morning. You're the priest of God.
Mm-hmm.
You name Jesus as Lord and Savior. You're a priest.
Thank you, Lord.
Does that make sense to you?
Amen.
So you have that twofold responsibility. You make sacrifices and you intercede on the behalf of others.
Amen.
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 So when you pray and pray that you do the will of God. So we have all this access to God, just like Aaron did.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. All right, Message Bible, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 through 24. Here we go. Ready? Be careful. Y'all all right? Be careful, no matter what. No, I'm sorry. That's not the word. Be cheerful. Final instruction. Don't be careful. The scripture said to be careful for nothing. Amen.
Yeah.
So we're not being anxious for nothing. But be cheerful.
Amen.
Somebody say, I'm going to be cheerful. As believers, we all have things happen in our lives. Bill Gephardt says it like this. We still live in a sinful world among sinful people. And so things happen. Amen. We have death in our families. We have sickness. We have all kinds of things that happen. And man, those things will rock your world.
Mm-hmm.
Won't they?
Amen.
But notice he says, be cheerful.
Mm-hmm.
What's King James say? Rejoice always or something like that?
Rejoice evermore.
Rejoice evermore?
Mm-hmm.
That's difficult, isn't it?
Hmm.
Hello?
Amen.
Let me give you a little bit about how to get there. Praying.
Amen.
Amen. Watching. And being lovers of the truth.
Amen.
Amen. Now, if you don't know what's in this book, you don't know the truth.
Amen.
Because when you encounter situations in real life, you're going to think that's happening is the truth.
Mm-hmm.
It's fact. It's fact. I agree with you. It's fact, not the truth.
Amen.
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 The word of God is truth. All right.
Amen.
So he says, be cheerful no matter what. Be cheerful no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
That takes a whole lot of rest on your behalf. A whole lot of letting go, backing up, saying, okay, I can't fix this.
Mm-hmm.
I no matter how I try, I can't fix this.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to look to the one who fixes all things,
mm-hmm.
who has the ability to fix all things. And I'm just going to thank you that you can fix it.
Amen.
I'm going to thank you that you fixed things before.
Mm-hmm.
Come on. I'm going to thank you that you are a fixer. Ooh, glory to God. I'm going to thank you that you said in your word, earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot hear. I'm going to thank you for that. Amen? So no matter what, I'm going to be cheerful.
Amen.
Woo! Come on, child of God.
Amen.
That's a job. He says, no matter what, you ought to be cheerful. Pray all the time. That is. Pray all the time. Thank God no matter what happens.
Amen.
Don't thank God for what happened. Thank God in what happened.
Amen.
But you got me. I don't understand this, but I know you're going to get something out of this, and you're going to turn it around somehow. You're going to get some glory.
Amen.
Yes. Yes. Thank you.
This is the way God wants you who belong to Christ Jesus to live. Mm-hmm. That's how he wants you to live.
Amen.
Verse 19. Don't suppress the spirit. Don't grieve. Don't stifle those who have a word from the master. Listen. Let me read the rest of that. On the other hand, don't be gullible. So watch this. People will come with a word from the Lord. Don't just say that ain't God. No, weigh it. Yeah. Find out if it's in line with the scripture.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
In other words, like he said, don't be gullible. Don't just jump on it because your favorite preacher said it.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Hello?
Amen.
Because your favorite preacher can miss it.
Amen.
We are some sensitive people when it comes to spiritual things.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll travel to go see the prophet.
Mm-hmm.
When you can get a word in your own house.
Amen.
Oh, come on.
Amen.
Watch this. I'm going to help you. When you have a more sure word of prophecy, these 66 books.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Are y'all hearing me? Now, that doesn't mean we shut the prophet out. Because I'm going to use an example here. A prophet that we were in line with here,
mm-hmm.
every year in January,
mm-hmm.
he would come, be a blessing to us, or every other year, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And he spoke something to me. I don't know how many of y'all remember
mm-hmm.
that he spoke this thing to me about mm-hmm. what I should go and do for another minister to make things flow in my life.
Right.
Well, things were already flowing in my life, Steve.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, he was talking about ministry-wise. Y'all remember another prophet had come and said, what you did in one spot, you'll do it in half the time.
Right.
Well, now why I got to go do something else
mm-hmm.
and we doing it in half the time?
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Are y'all hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
So don't be gullible. Don't say that ain't God.
Mm-hmm.
Weigh it.
Yeah.
Know what the word says. Pray about it. Amen.
Amen.
So watch this. I try to never, help me, Lord, never have somebody to come in here and say, okay, this going to be a blessing for you if you can give $50 or if you can give $1,000. No.
Mm-hmm.
No, Negro, please. We don't live like that no more.
Amen.
Mm-mm. That's not the will of God. Listen, I got an honorarium for you.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all hear me? Mm-hmm. So I'm not letting people make merchandise out of y'all no more.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Y'all get it?
Amen.
You take the honor rim. If that's not good enough for you, well, so will be. All right. Is that good?
Amen.
So he said, don't be gullible. Check out everything. And keep only what's good. Like Vincent Robinson says.
Mm-hmm.
Eat the meat and spit out the fat.
Yeah.
Throw out anything tainted with evil.
Mm-hmm.
Throw it out.
Because
mm-hmm. sometimes when people prophesy, they put a little bit of themselves in it.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 23.
Mm-hmm.
May God himself, the God who makes everything holy, and whole make you holy and whole. Put you together, spirit and soul, spirit, soul, and body,
mm-hmm.
and keep you fit for the coming of the Master,
mm-hmm.
Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
The one who is called you is completely dependable. If he said it, he'll do it.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, I want you to pay close attention to something. because when I read it, I kind of missed it, but Holy Spirit helped me. He said, verse 23, may God himself, the God who makes everything holy and whole, makes you holy and whole.
Mm-hmm.
Put you together,
mm-hmm.
spirit, soul, and body.
Mm-hmm.
There are some things that you can't do
mm-hmm.
on your own.
Yeah.
Only God can do
it. Amen. Amen.
You can't make yourself whole.
Mm-hmm. That's
right.
You can't make yourself holy. He said, be ye holy,
yeah.
for I am holy. Amen.
Amen.
Now, I shared this with you years ago. It simply means you must be holy because I'm holy.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, when Mama, Pastor Jackie, and I went to dinner at a restaurant,
mm-hmm.
we walk in, the ladies are ahead of me, they go into the table, Stephen, and this guy is sitting there at the table with his lady eating. I walk in, I say, how you doing, sir? He said, how you doing? You must be a Creagh. So when he says, you must be holy,
mm-hmm.
for I am holy,
mm-hmm.
it simply means because you in him, you got his DNA,
yeah.
when people see you, they say, oh, he must be holy because
yeah.
he holy.
Mm-hmm.
You look like him.
Mm-hmm.
You talk like him.
Yeah.
You walk like. I looked at that guy. I said, yeah, old Creagh. How you know me? He said, man, I can tell him Creagh anyway. And I said, your face look familiar. Who are you? He told me his name. I said, yeah, man, I can see it now. You want them Lucy's. I can see it. Listen,
yeah.
are people being able to say, you must be holy?
Mm-hmm.
They can see it.
Mm-hmm.
They can tell that you in him and he's in you. Listen, don't forget. You can't do it by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
You can't do it on your own.
Mm-hmm.
You can't be holy. You can't be righteous without him.
Mm-hmm.
You can be a reflection of him because he's in you.
Mm-hmm.
But when you try to do it on your own, when you take it and try to fix it, make it right yourself, 9 times out of 10, and I'll dare say 10 out of 10,
mm-hmm.
you're going to become a reflection on mm-hmm. him,
yeah.
not of him.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Y'all get anything out of that today?
Amen, amen, amen.
If you got some, I need to hear some. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen. For those of you who are watching us, and I can't say enough about it, thank you so much for watching us by social media. But for those of you who are watching us by social media, you need to know the Lord.
Amen.
Not just say, I know of him, but you need to have that intimacy with him. Jesus, Yahshua himself, needs to be Savior and Lord in your life.
Amen.
He is Savior and Lord. Will you allow him to be for you? Amen. Y'all going to help him? Let's help him. Say it with me. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on. In the name of Jesus.
If you're on social media, say it like this. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I believe. Jesus died.
Jesus died.
For my sins.
For my sins.
I confess. I need a Savior.
I need a Savior.
Right now.
Right now.
I believe.
I receive.
Him as Lord.
Him as Lord.
And as Savior.
And as Savior.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
So if you've done that, you are born again.
Amen.
You are right with God.
Amen.
Now, if you're looking for a church home, we believe it's the best one in town.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Come on, we're doing social distancing. You can wear your mask.
Amen.
Checking your temperature at the door. All those kind of things. They even have me on a clock. So I usually stop when it goes off. I sometimes stop. Amen. Come on, fellowship with us.
Amen.
You need what the word of God has to offer.
Amen.
Nothing like it.
Amen.
Praise God. Well, it's offering time. How you feel about giving?
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
If you're an Alabama fan, you have to give double today.
Praise God.
Amen. Listen, there's four ways to give. Don't forget, you can do it by Cash App. Cash App is $SpiritAndTruthCC. $SpiritAndTruthCC. You can do it by Church App. The most secure way to do it is #STCC. #STCC to 54244. 54244. Man, you get that out and it'll work for you every time. It's really secure. Also, you can do it by PayPal. PayPal is SpiritAndTruthChristianCenter@gmail.com. Spell it all out. SpiritAndTruthChristianCenter@gmail.com. And then finally, you can do it by snail mail. Mail it to us. Put it in the mail. Put a stamp on it. Lick it and all that kind of stuff. And go to P.O. Box 632. Mount Vernon, Alabama, 36560. Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Y'all all right?
Amen.
Got your offering together? Lift it high. Lift it high. Say it with me. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
This seed I sow.
This seed I sow.
Causes me to be out of debt.
Causes me to be out of debt.
And all my needs are met.
All my needs are met.
And I have much more.
And I have much more.
To put in store.
To put in store.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Come on.
Amen. Amen.
Praise God.